finished my BCom, I used to see Capuchin friars walking with the sand in their hand, walking on the, just, you know, all the time I used to look at them, too many stones they'll be carrying, and to the friary with the brown habit. I used to wonder, why don't I become like this? Then I went and told my father. He said, no, this is very hard life, you won't make it. Then my mother also said, no, but if you pray, you will make it. Then my sister, all were discouraging me that I should not go, because they loved me, in fact. But I said, I would like to go. That's the first time I went inside. On the first day, the superior came and told, brothers, please get up. It was around 1 o'clock in the morning. So we said, why? No, there are some stones to be collected. Do you know, there was three loads of tiles to be collected from one counter. Until morning, 4 o'clock, we were collecting. Broken and pained so much, you know. And I was telling that, okay, man, this is only a pre-taste of what is going to come. So I phoned to my mother and said, I think it is going to be very hard. I will not make it. She said, no, my son, you be there, I'll pray for you. And today I'm still a priest because of my mother's prayer and father's blessing. Both were very dedicated Catholics, poor people, but very good to put me through. And I completed my studies. As soon as I completed my studies, this offer came. Who wants to go to mission? Because we were 7 of them who got a distinction. So they were asking us to go for higher studies. So I thought, anytime in our life we can go for higher studies, but we can't go for mission anytime. You know, if you are 60, you can't go for mission. So when we are in the prime time of our life, let's go. So I told my companion nearby, shall we go? He said, no, you go, I'll pray for you. I said, okay, man. But still I convinced him that we both went to that side. It's a very beautiful country, a blanket of beauty you will see everywhere, with all its richness of God's blessing. And mission-wise, it is very challenging. Moving around, meeting people is very far from each other place. And I also feel that without God, you can't do that kind of mission. And you need to be focused on God, and God accompanies you in all your struggles. The first time when I saw people, I thought, my God, when will I learn this language? This language is very too powerful for me, as I myself struggled to learn English. Now another language to learn, especially Ndebele, all these are very powerful when you pronounce and speak. For example, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, the Holy Spirit, we say, so in every statement you will see a click will come. And that was the beginning. And the food also was a challenge for me. And I am a vegetarian, but you know, Zimbabwean people are full of non-vegetarian. Everywhere you go, there will be non-vegetarian food. So still, that was another challenge, I found it. And to connect with the people was very hard for first 2 years because of the lack of language. Because you can talk a little bit, but still you have to follow some people to know and understand. Old people are very good with the children. They teach you.
Okay.
Whenever in the mass, you know, really we will learn and to connect it and correct it also.
Okay.
That's the way. And Zimbabwe, it's a very poor country. As it stands, it's one of the poorest country in Africa. Yeah, because now we don't have currency from 2004. There is no currency in Zimbabwe. We only depend on either on US dollar or on any other foreign currency nearby, like South Africa rand. But who has that money? God only knows. So it is very hard for Zimbabwean. Today it's really a most hardest time. Children struggle more because some of the villages, there are no schools.
Okay.
Especially our side, in Ndebele side, not many schools.
Okay.
There is also a majority tribal group called Shona. I am working with Ndebele people. Shona people are very rich and very affluent. powerful. They got the schools in every 20 kilometers. But our side, if you come, some of our children walk about 30 kilometers, 40 kilometers in the forest looking for schools now. First thing, but when I saw people were walking looking for water, my heart was broken. Women just carrying small tin of water, walking 10 kilometers, for me it was unacceptable. Women were walking in the forest. I said, where are these people walking? They said, they are going to deliver the baby. Okay. How long they walk? They said, about 30 kilometers, sometimes 40, some are 68. Then I said,
hospitals are that much
very
far?
Very far. Okay. It is not indeed a hospital, it's a clinic.
Okay.
So I thought, why not I take this as a new ministry for the church? So I said, I will carry all women to the hospital.
In my car.
That's a mission car.
Okay.
And every lady who was near the mission, whether they are Catholics, non-Catholics, as long as they are mothers, I carry them.
Okay.
Do you know how many children are named after my name? Because that's the outer of gratitude, no?
Okay.
I say, Father, we'd like to thank you that our child will be called Peter. Or Petrina.
Okay.
So many, no, you really feel, see how God rewards you, your work and the way you touch people. It's, yes, we need prayer, we need to make them to come closer to Christ, but the values of Christ, the values of the kingdom, that if we translate it in their own way and put it through, they're automatically in the church.
Okay.
That's what I see it now. Another important thing I did was, one day I was celebrating Mass in the forest and all of a sudden people all ran away. I said, where are they running, man? They said, well, the lions have come. So, you know, you pack your things and put it in the car and then you also run away. And I said, no, we need a church here. I used to pray for 6 years for the church to be built.
Okay.
in the place where I used to go for Mass. Every time we go under a tree, we set the table and we celebrate. And some good people helped me. Now I built seven churches so far. Six are in the forest.
Remote area.
Yeah, one in the city. City parish is little bigger though.
Uh-huh.
But look at, now people have no fear to come to church.
Yeah,
even there are animals around, they know we are in a safe place. Elephants come, lions come, they will come, they go. Because they are inside the church. It is because of some of the generous heart of people like that. Some always pray for me and support me, send me message to say, Father, we are thinking of you, praying for you. Really pushes you to work some. In the Vele, it's an offshoot of Zulu,
okay.
One of the tough sub-Saharan languages.
Okay.
But if you commit yourself, sit and read, and even some of the missionaries find it hard because of the clicks.
Okay.
But you read every day a little bit and listen to this all these things. It is very easy to learn.
Okay.
And people love you when you preach in their language.
Okay.
Yeah, they love it. Even if you preach 2 hours, they will be sitting and listening to it.
Uh-huh.
I prepare my sermon in the Vele and prepare it, print it, and put it in their WhatsApp group so that they also read.
Uh-huh.
All these things are very good, even for us and for them too. Then people will begin to come. The parish I went to, there were not many people. After I went there, even now people say, Father, just for your preaching, so many people come. So if you really sit and prepare the whole week, you are going to pull crowds. And the Lord will be glorified when people come. They are going to, few of them are going to change. Many African people are serious with their religious life. The mission is that you take one extra step with all its inconvenience for Jesus. That's what I say. It is not preaching or teaching. Our life becomes a teaching for people. Even the students I stay with, they say, ah, Father, we would like to become like you because the way you pray attracts us more. And it is not the word that we speak, but the way we live in the community, in the way we are among them. Because these are people who are looking for God. And if I cannot make them to spark a connection, and then it cannot happen without prayer. I believe It is the personal prayer of a missionary that makes us to evangelize us better.
Pope Francis met with national representatives of the Pontifical Missionary Societies and asked them to prepare the extraordinary missionary month scheduled for October of 2019 very well. Pope Francis says it will be an opportunity to renew the faith and missionary commitment of the entire church.
Sempre si devono rinnovare le cose, rinnovare il cuore, rinnovare le opere, rinnovare le organizzazioni, perché dal contrario finiremo tutti in un museo.
Pope Francis remembered that the motto of that extraordinary month will be baptized and sent out, the Church of Christ on a mission in the world. This involves making each Christian responsible, since the missionary attitude starts from baptism and not from a special consecration.
It's a very, you know, important, significant. Church cannot exist without evangelizing. Evangelii Nunciandi, the document, number 56. And it clearly tells the church cannot go on by just running a school or this and that, but it has to evangelize. But you need evangelizers who would be able to leave their own mother country, motherland, and go elsewhere, willing to learn a new language, willing to adopt a new culture, and to share their faith with other people. And that is abutted. Many are called, but very few are chosen. But I find within the mission vocation, I think it's a very special call. And God calls some guys that he wants for himself. And that is what Pope is now inviting the whole world. Please pray for these missionaries and please support them. And also you, on your part, be a missionary somewhere in some place for a few months or a week or something. That is very encouraging for us as Pope Francis. And Pope Francis is a very simple, a person who is building the church with this evangelization. The commitment that you are willing to leave what you like most.
Okay.
You may like most your country of origin, or your mother and father, or your sister who you love most. All the things have to let go. And then if we are able to make a sacrifice, that I like to be there. And it really makes a sense. People will feel, you know, when my mother died, I was celebrating Mass. Somebody came and whispered to me, people are waiting to see you. Then I finished my Mass, I came full of women in front of the house. What is 200 women were there?
While you are there in Zimbabwe?
Yeah, in Zimbabwe, I'm saying.
Okay.
Then I asked what happened. Ah, no, Father, we are sorry to tell you that your mother passed away.
Okay.
And all these mothers are telling me that look at the number of the mothers you have now.
Okay.
You know, what else you would a missionary need than all this such a love you would have? They're all African people. And I am an Indian, but they adopt me into this.
Their family.
Yeah, you know, on that day I arrived here, it was Friday night I came, Saturday I celebrated Mass. I said, I'm there in Zimbabwe for 23 years. African community called me and said, you are not Indian, you are African. You come with us for meeting. I was with them.
Okay.
You see the affinity, that is a special thing that we can always make, and people will be pulled towards us like that.
Okay.
My youngest sister died. My superior came and told me, your sister passed away. So I asked Father, am I allowed to go? No, Father Peter, you have to pray for him. You know, that was my most painful time in this whole thing. Then just I went there, within 2 years' time, I see this thing is happening. Then only I knew the weight and the sacrifice of the mission. Then I knew, okay, be prepared for the worst. There are many more things that are going to come. Still we need to focus here where we are planted. No, God was so good. 1989 Capuchins went. And they were training many people. Many were not joined. But when our group went, many youngsters were attracted, seeing us.
Okay.
Even one boy came and told me, Father, I want to be like you. And now he is in theology.
Oh.
So when you see these youngsters, they are pulled to your lifestyle and the way you are among the people, because people watch you. People watch you very closely, who you are, what you are, who do you relate with, who do you connect with. Everything is very... African people watch everything.
Okay.
Only then they make an assessment of you to tell. They don't just gossip. They want to see you, how you are living inside and outside. And that really makes me to see, oh, we can bring many more. Now we have got 11 Capuchins from Zimbabwe.
From Zimbabwean origin.
Origin.
Okay, okay.
So you know how blessed, when we look at, oh, these are the fruits of our hard work, what we have.
Next question, where are you getting this power from?
It's a prayer, personal prayer. Okay. I really feel a missionary who prays privately will be able to do mighty works outside. It is not a skill, it is not erudition or intelligence, no. It is the time we spent with the Lord in a private way, and it really works. For example, I get up 2:45 every day.
2:45?
Every day I get up. Other day they dropped me around 1 o'clock here. Then I went to bed, I got up 2:45.
It's an automatic...
Yeah, problem. Because otherwise you feel something is not okay. And therefore you really... That is what I really think it is giving us, that force and energy. And there is no tiredness, honestly. Even if I have to celebrate 3 masses, 4 masses, no tiredness. But where you get energy? Early morning with the Lord.
And 2:45?
Yeah, every day, 2:45. And really it helps you. And just after 3 o'clock, I like Divine Mercy as my source.
Okay.
I love that devotion. Two is Padre Pio.
Uh-huh.
Intercession of Padre Pio and Divine Mercy every day. And our beloved Mother Mary. I love it. Many of the times I find when I'm alone, lonely, I just go to the statue of Mother Mary, I sit there. I don't know where I get the strength, and you begin to function. Most of the missions I was there, I was alone. But never been attacked or, a robber comes, nothing. When the Lord guards your house, nobody's going to touch you. This is what I feel. And the energy is prayer. Personal prayer is the energy. If you don't pray, you get misfocused and you become tired. When we are working for the Lord, I feel it is not for our favor, our benefit we do. When you work for the Lord, Spirit of the Lord simply leads you. And the power, the word power, and that creativity power, the energy that the children need. Many children say, one boy came and told me that day, this is the mass I wanted to attend. After the, sometimes that the mass, he said, it was super. I enjoyed it, he said. Each fellow was coming and telling me at the back of the church. I said to them, keep going. You must meet Christ in the mass. So now children will really think, it is easy to... With the children, we need a lively mass.
Yeah,
a lot of energy will go. But how many will give such energy, that is up to each one's generosity to the Lord. Sometimes I feel, the other day after speaking, I was also a little tired because of the so many travels.
Okay.
But still I said, no, many children benefited on that day. Even some parents brought some children and said, Father, they said today's mass was very good, they were touched like that. I said, so that means energy is interest. If you show interest for people and kids, some of us have got a problem that we will have interest for adults. When it comes for children, these are children only. No, we need to give triple the amount of energy to the kids than the adults. If that we do it, I think we are successful. And it comes. when we prepare for the Lord, it does come.
Yeah, that's what I'm asking. Even when you're making that homily, you are using all the gestures.
Gestures are very important.
Your voice and everything, it is.
And people, and children get involved. Ah, we never heard like this. And they let us involve. Even small children, they feel, this is different than the other mass. Even for George made a comment, it's very, very good for the excellent, he said. But I said, no, Father, this is what we need to do for kids. And kids will really come closer to the Lord and say, I want to know about Jesus. I want to read the Bible, all these things. During the Pentecostal Sunday time, no, we used to fast 10 days. I tell my parishioners also and the mission people, would you like to fast with me? I would like to fast with me. Morning to afternoon or evening, you fast with me, write your name and give me.
Okay.
So, you know, how many fast? My God. I was really thrilled the first time when I heard the number of people were fasting. They come in the morning, spend the time with the Holy Eucharist, and they fast. And on that day of anointing, just I don't touch people. People fall like, just like that, dama, like that. Because of the power of the prayer and that fasting you took, and those so many people prayed with you, they will be all there. And so Pentecostal Sunday, you come and see how many people and how much of satanic manifestation. All this you see everything. So after you wait for that
particular day,
waiting for the 10 days to fast and that anointing, and they see. And they also tell me, Father, this is final dream to die as a missionary. Yeah, and I would like to really pray that the Lord may accept my, this longing to be a missionary until my last breath. Though the leaders are asking me to serve other capacities, but still I believe this is what many people don't want to come for it. And I only encourage the youngsters who are listening that they may be able to respond to Christ in a way that they will be proud of one day. I have walked an extra mile for Jesus, and Jesus will surely bless me. Sia zama ukuluma sindavele that uchumayela sindavele katesi ufuna ukunika uJesu. Ufuna ukunika uJesu uthemba uNkulunkulu kuphela. Zama ukuhamba phambili uNkulunkulu ealtareni. uNkulunkulu uyalithanda kakhulu sibili. uNkulunkulu uyalibusisa sibili. Siyazama ukubona sonke esulwini nale phezulu. Amen. Thank you. I said, come, let us see Jesus. And Jesus is the one who allows us to trust in God, and that God of ours will make us to live in heaven one day, which we all are privileged to have it. Amen.